Hello everyone, I'm Meena. Welcome back to another session with skillActz. I just received an email from a young friend, Satish, about work we are collaborating on. This is the message. What do you think of this message? Hope you realize this is not the right way to write an email to a colleague, client, or boss. Though we rarely use pen and paper to write letters, we do correspond with colleagues, bosses, family, and friends. We use emails, Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp. In your professional working life, you will be using emails as the mode of communication. Let's start with some quick but important tips to maintain etiquette in emails. There's another video you can watch to know more about how to write an email. Tip 1. Avoid slang, abbreviations, the kind that we use in text language. See you, for example, also, that's awesome or cool. A better word would be, that's a wonderful idea. So in Satish's mail, the words hi and with should be hi Meena or hello Meena, and with should be expanded to video. Avoid words in uppercase and bold. Uppercase and bold are interpreted as shouting, and that's really not your intent, isn't it? That's tip number 2. But do you remember to use capitals where necessary? Tip 3. It's better to avoid underlining. If you have to use it in a report or a proposal to highlight a point or to underline the heading, that's fine. Tip 4. Use short sentences and use simple and good language. This you can see in Satish's mail too. Use sentences that are aimed towards the person. Use you and your. It connects better with the recipient. For example, instead of writing, I would like to inform you that your proposal has been accepted, you could say, you will be glad to know that we have accepted your proposal. People at work are busy and receive many emails. If you want the recipient to read your email, keep your communication short and to the point. Be brief and clear. That's tip 5. A point connected with this is to mention the most important point at the very beginning of your email. It doesn't mean you plunge right in like Satish has done, but come to the point quickly. That's another tip. Number 6. Tip 7. Avoid too many attachments with your email. Also, stay away from using emoticons in formal emails. There's a saying, don't judge a book by its cover. But there is something to be said about looks and first impressions. That's tip 8 coming your way. I'm talking about email IDs. Most of us created email IDs when we were in school or in college, and so we use some cool, fancy names. But imagine you are applying to a company now. So before you start doing that, create a professional ID. Everyone knows that, but there are a few things that you must bear in mind. Imagine you want to mail a thank you to the HR of the company that has made you an offer. What do you think the HR will think when he sees your email ID? coolraj007@gmail.com or supergirl@yahoo.com. Technically, there's nothing wrong with these IDs, but professionally, they are inappropriate. It's a good idea to have an ID that has your first and last names. Keep things simple. It's also easy for the other person to remember. So, for example, my ID could be meena.nair@gmail.com or nair.meena@gmail.com. Tip 9. Always review and recheck your email. Check to ensure it is as you want it before pressing that send button. Be proud of the email that you are sending. And before we close, let's look at the email I showed you at the very beginning. Better, isn't it? In this video, I have discussed 9 tips on email etiquette. Hope you will go through the video again and will remember and use these tips the next time you write an email. Every time you sit down to write a mail, think of the person to whom you're sending it. What is it that you want to communicate? And write the email appropriately. Mark Twain has said this about making an impromptu speech. It usually takes me 3 weeks to make a speech. Similarly, If not 3 weeks, take some time and make the effort to craft a good email. Remember to edit and review it before hitting send. Create a good impression in the mind of the recipient. Good luck. Have you come across strange emails like Satish's? If you have, please share your experience in the comments below. Please subscribe to our channel SkillActz and hit the like button.